Welcome to Unapologetically Sensitive, a place to find connection and a sense of belonging, where you can learn, relate, laugh, and maybe even live a bolder, brighter life. I'm your host, Patricia Young. This is a weekly podcast where we talk about sensitivity and the richness that it adds, the strengths we have because of our sensitivity, and some of the challenges it poses as well. The information in this podcast is not a substitute for help from a licensed mental health professional. Hey there. I was not planning on doing any more follow-ups to bonus episode 56 and 58 entitled, I Wasn't Invited, Why, This Sucks, Now What? And there's been a new development, and this is what I do when something happens and I'm just trying to process things. So my gremlins are saying, like, you need to stop talking about your personal business on your podcast. So I just want to call out my gremlins. It's really interesting. This morning, I was messaging with the mom who moved away, and I said that we'd come out and visit her because she had cancer and was going through treatment. And so this morning, we just had a little connection, and then I got a voice message. Actually, my phone rang from one of the other moms in the group that's here in San Diego. And I kind of panicked. I have a podcast interview in another hour and we're going out of town. So I have a lot going on and I'm feeling pretty preoccupied. But my heart started to beat when the phone rang and I chose not to pick it up. I feel like I really want to stay focused on what I need to do this morning. We're leaving to go out of town. When the interview is over, I had to cancel a massage for this afternoon, which is my once a month self-care. And I usually stay and do all of my podcasting stuff. And because my son's going through some stuff, we're going to go out of town and support him this weekend. And my other son's coming with us. So I'm looking forward to it. It's just for my little HSP self, it's a lot of last minute preparation. So I'm doing laundry and my phone rings and my heart starts to pound and I let it roll over to voicemail because I just need to stay focused. And what this other mom said is that there were some extenuating circumstances or some things that I'm not aware of that happened about why I wasn't included, and she wanted to talk to me about it. It's just really interesting. The reason why I'm sharing with you is I feel like I'm 12 years old again. I'm going through this, did I do something wrong? Did I say something wrong? I'm thinking back to both episodes. Did I blame anybody? Did I make judgments about maybe there were extenuating circumstances of why I wasn't involved, why I wasn't invited? You know, it's just so interesting how our nervous systems can be so finely tuned. And I feel like I'm in this place where I feel like I did something wrong and I'm 12. The nice thing is the mom that had moved away, I messaged her and we just had a really nice little talk and she was incredibly supportive. And what I know is that when something happens and I have a strong emotional response, I'm a verbal processor and it really helps to be able to talk to somebody just about what's going on with me. But I'm sharing this because I think that it's so common for us to go into that place of, I did something wrong. I need to apologize. I need to make another podcast saying, you know, there were extenuating circumstances and I didn't know. I also went into this place of, well, two things. One is, I really thought I'd move through this. I was just talking to my husband this morning when I was talking to this other mom who lives out of town about how easily I moved through this whole thing. And in the past, it really would have taken me down for a long time. So I had this sense of esteem of, you know, I'm really doing a great job working through my stuff and I'm not getting reactive and I'm not getting triggered. And then this thing happened and I kind of go down the other path of like, oh my gosh, I'm not as healed as I thought I was. And I'm feeling guilty and I'm thinking I did something wrong and not wanting to pick up the phone and kind of that shame-based stuff. So I just want to name it. I want to model it that it's very possible to be incredibly courageous, to speak our truth, to have a lot of fear, to have a lot of doubt, to get triggered, to go into very young feelings of feeling like we've done something wrong. And it doesn't mean that we're not courageous, and it doesn't mean that we don't continue to speak our truth. And in this circumstance, maybe there is more information that I'm not aware of, but like my head is going through this place of wanting to justify that it's like, well, if it was something else, then why the heck did you post on social media where I could see and get my feelings hurt? And I really want to go back to this thing of people have a right to post anywhere they want. People have a right to have get-togethers anytime. They don't have to invite anybody that they don't want to have there for whatever reason. I'm trying to think of the most outrageous situation. that would have meant that, you know, maybe there's something going on with one of them and they're all involved and it doesn't relate to me. I mean, I have no idea. They have a right to do that. And it's really okay for me to have any kind of reaction that I have. I think what makes this a little bit unique is that I have a podcast and I talk about it, and it's not my intention to spread dirty laundry all over the podcast waves, but it is to talk about what comes up for us and to open up dialogues, because stuff happens all the time in relationships. It may have a little bit of a different flavor, but I really want to pull the curtain back on having it be okay that we have reactions, that we feel like we're 12 years old, that our heart is pounding, that we don't pick up the phone because we just are not in a place where we want to deal with something right now, that no matter what feelings come up, whether it's joy or happiness or a feeling of being left out or sadness or jealousy or any of those things, all of our feelings are okay. And we need to find ways that we can honor the feelings that come up. We hopefully have people around us that can support us when we do have things that come up. And then we've got tools that we can bring ourselves back to balance. And I still may have some heart pounding going on. I still may have some thinking about, did I say something wrong? It's very possible that what I may do is go back and listen to both episodes through the lens of somebody who had something going on and didn't invite me because it wasn't a good fit or it didn't match whatever was going on, to see, like, did I say something that from that perspective, I might have been insensitive. And I've done this a few times when I've had relationship issues and I've talked about the struggles that I'm having. I've listened to an episode with the ear of that person. If they were listening, how would it sound? Because it's very easy for us to see things from our point of view and to not be as empathic about how it's going for somebody else. In fact, this morning, it's really interesting. My husband and I spontaneously decided to go up to stay overnight where my son is going to college. We decided yesterday, and I'm not a really spontaneous person. And so this is kind of a big deal. And my other son is coming. We rented an Airbnb. My son's girlfriend and my son we'll all be staying there together. And this morning, my husband was planning on spending some time with the son that lives here at home. And they're doing some things that have to do with Christmas. And we're trying to figure out when we're going to leave. I normally, when I record an interview, I need a good 2 hours, an hour for the interview, hour and 15 minutes. And then I like to do the intro and outro, get the show notes, because it's all fresh in my mind. And if we want to leave and get there in time to hopefully spend a little time with him before he goes to work, I mean, we've got like a window of an hour and a half. We need to leave pretty quickly when I'm done recording the interview. So I'm cutting things short. I'm trying to get my stuff ready to go. My husband was saying he didn't want to cut time short with my son this morning. And I've told you about my taskmaster, who has very little empathy and is really just about getting the job done. And one of the things that is a strength for my husband is he can get very single-minded and get things done, but he also sometimes misses the big picture, where sometimes I get so focused on what I'm doing that this analogy isn't working, so I'm just going to drop it. So anyways, this morning I was saying, you have until Christmas time to do this task with my son or our son, and we only have this little window of time to spend with our other son. And he told me later on that what he didn't tell me was that he was really looking forward to spending time with Daniel, is the one that's at home. So he was really looking forward to spending time with Daniel, not only accomplishing the task, and he didn't want to have to lose that time because we had to rush to go see Josh, our other son. And he didn't share that with me. And it really opened a nice discussion, because I've been feeling really impatient, and I was able to say, thanks for saying that. He said, had you had this information, you know, maybe your response would have been softer or kinder. And it's like, it's possible, but maybe not. And then I was able to talk about my taskmaster, who gets really impatient and frustrated because sometimes, you know, my husband gets very focused on one thing, and this is my lack of empathy. You have until Christmas to get this done. And if you do it next week and you still have time, it does not take into account the fact that he wants to spend time with Daniel, and that if they cut their time short, then that's really what he was addressing. But again, these are all the things that if we don't talk about it, we don't know. So I felt impatient with my husband. He felt like I was short with him. And then we had this really lovely discussion. So this is really about talking about the things that go on. And then the other part of this is that, you know, my husband and I were talking about, I'm going to rush when I'm done doing this interview so we can leave. He's shortening his time with Daniel so we can get up there. We don't know if Josh and his girlfriend are going to have time to spend time with us. And so I texted Josh and his girlfriend and said, hey, we're just trying to figure out what your time frame looks like because we're planning to leave at 1, but we don't really want to rush up there. If you guys have things going on, there's no pressure. So that's the other dynamic that can come into play is often, you know, we could rush to get there expecting them to be available and they may not be planning to spend time with us today. And then we end up feeling angry and resentful because we could have taken our time. We could have spent the day a little bit more leisurely. So this is another area where communicating is really, really important. And kind of the overreaching message of this podcast is there really is no right or wrong way of doing things. We're going to make mistakes if we are able to communicate and then go back in and recommunicate and go back in again and recommunicate. That's really what it's about. It's not about doing anything perfectly. We're going to have our judgments, our impatience, whatever it is that comes up for us. And we can still talk about it, own it. And like I told my husband today, like, I will try and be more empathic in the future. I'm just not always super empathic. And especially when my taskmaster is up, she doesn't care about empathy. She just wants to get shirt done. So anyways, there may be a follow-up to this if there's more information that feels like it's relevant to the two previous episodes that I released. But this really is about imperfection, about our humanity, about just showing up and being where we need to be and letting it all be okay. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're going to make mistakes. We're going to miscommunicate. We're not going to see everything from the most empathic point of view. And can we have compassion for ourselves? Can we have compassion for others? And just know that we're doing the best that we can. Hey there. So I'm going to jump back on. I do have a little follow-up to this conversation about what happened regarding me returning the mom's call, who I didn't pick up. But I wanted to let you know about a meetup event that's coming up. If you're listening in real time, on Saturday, October 5th, 2019, if you live in San Diego or near San Diego, from 10 to 12, we're going to do another meetup. We're going to be doing these on the first Saturday of every month. This one is going to be at Morley Field. If you go to meetup.com and you look up the highly sensitive person, HSP, it's listed there, but I'm going to tell you where it is. I'd prefer if you RSVP, but if you can show up, I would love to meet you and see you. It's going to be on Jacaranda Drive, which is just a little bit south of Upis between Jacaranda Place and Upis on Jacaranda Drive. Please bring a chair, a blanket, something to sit on. There's more information if you go to the Facebook page, Unapologetically Sensitive, the closed Facebook group, but I would love to see you there. And so let's hear the rest of the story. Hey there. So this is a follow-up to what I previously recorded, and I just wanted to jump on. And again, I want to be really clear about the reason why I'm sharing this information with you is to really pull the curtain back on what happens when we have these kind of bumps and how do we process, and when we have more time where we're processing it and having a harder time letting it go, I just want to create normalization around it so that we don't beat ourselves up. And I feel like I've really kind of been in the midst of this, and it's been a while since something like this has kind of pulled this much of my time and attention. And so the best thing I know how to do is to talk about it. I had shared with you that I had gotten a call from one of the moms who left a message and wanted to talk to me and give me some information to help me understand, I'm guessing, why I wasn't included. And I texted with her a little bit and we tried to coordinate a time and it just didn't work. And I went out of town with my family for the weekend, and the following day I really had this burden, like, I really need to call her. I really need to get the information. And every time I thought about it, my heart just started to pound. It's what I call getting activated. And to me, that means like my heart would start to pound. I had spent time between the time I'd received her phone call and this time thinking, what information could she give me that would make me feel differently? This is all my projection. So I want to be really clear about the reason why I'm sharing this is what goes on for us. And I kind of thought, so if she gives me a quote, valid reason about why I wasn't included, does that mean that I shouldn't have had the reaction that I did? I shouldn't have felt hurt. I shouldn't have felt left out. And I really had to practice that my reaction was my reaction. I did go back and listen to both episodes that I recorded. And in the first one, I said, like, it felt like it was mean that I wasn't included. I was having those feelings, and I'm not going to say that I should change it. The truth is, we tend to take things really personally, and we tend to make things about ourselves. Whatever reaction we have is fine. I guess if I could go back now and amend it, and I'm not saying that I need to amend it, everybody has a right to do what they want to do. And for whatever reason, they had a reason for not including me. I had a reaction. Neither one of those things is wrong. And I do think that there is this place where we tend to take things personally. We feel hurt. I'm not saying we should or we shouldn't, and I don't want to go back and retract anything that I said. What happened for me is I was out of town this weekend and thinking that I really needed to call her back and get information, I found myself feeling activated. And I was thinking, what if she says something? Do I want to be open with her with processing? Do I just want to put on what I call my Stepford wife face and go, okay, thank you for giving me that information? I kind of had this perspective of I was invited and I got hurt. And what do I need to do to heal? It was kind of an either or thing. And now there was a third option that was being presented, that maybe there was another perspective that I hadn't considered. And I was having these feelings of like, I was wrong for not thinking that there was another perspective. I should be more open to having another perspective. It really triggered a lot for me. And what I decided was I really didn't want to have the information about why I wasn't included, that the episode and my intention for sharing. My intention for sharing was just to model what it looks like when we go through this process. Gracie's going to be barking in a minute. And I really felt like I, in air quote, should be open to listening to what she had to say. And it wasn't okay for me to set a limit. And I was not being very open. I mean, these are all the messages that I was giving to myself. And then because it reactivated me, I thought, I really haven't done any healing, and this is really triggering for me, and I'm having upset over it, so I'm not doing it right. And what I really had to do was to know that I really get to choose what I want to have in my life and what I don't want to have. And the gremlins also said, you know, maybe there's a way of restoring this relationship. Maybe I jumped to conclusions. I definitely went through this thing of like, why do I process what's going on with me on a podcast? I don't have any boundaries. I shouldn't be doing this. I really thought about, you know, is it fair to, I want to use the word sacrifice, which is a strong word, sacrifice personal relationships, the relationships that I have with these women, in order to talk about it on a podcast so that I'm modeling how do we go through these things, and this benefits far more people than the few people, but maybe I'm injuring or hurting the few people that I talk about. Should I be doing this? I mean, it really brought up a lot for me. This may change in the future. I may change not processing what goes on, but I really do believe that my intention for sharing is to provide modeling, and it's not to call anybody out. It's not to throw anybody under the bus. It's to help model how, as deep feelers and deep thinkers, do we go through these things in life when it sticks with us and it brings up stuff for us, and then we think we've got it figured out, and then something else shows up, and then it's harder to let go of. I really want to talk about how we do this so that we just feel okay about it. Today is Monday. I got the call from her on Saturday. We went out of town Sunday. I've been talking about this. I overdid it this weekend, so I'm feeling pretty depleted today. And what I know is I'm just going to have to be gentle with myself this week. If I can take some more breaks in my schedule, I noticed that I'm having this tendency to want to take things personally. I invited somebody to be on the podcast, somebody that I'm friends with, and she declined a number of times. And this morning I just watched her do an interview somewhere else, and it was an amazing interview. And I'm finding that I want to go to that place of taking it personally. How come she doesn't want to be on my show and blah, blah, blah. And I know that I'm more vulnerable right now. And the truth is, it doesn't really matter why she doesn't want to be on. And I can choose to take it personally, take it as an affront, take it as an injury, or I can go, you know what? It doesn't matter. This doesn't support her. And I can get other guests. So I know that right now I'm more vulnerable. I'm going to be more sensitive. I'm probably going to be more emotionally reactive. I'm drained. And that's okay. One of the things I heard today that I loved, Ariana Smith, who's a highly sensitive therapist in Colorado, was talking on the Sensitivity Summit about HSPs and the analogy of the bathtub, that as highly sensitive people, our bathtubs fill up really quickly. That's the overwhelm, the overstimulation, the overarousal, and they drain very slowly. So the time that it takes us to recoup after we get overstimulated, where a non-HSP's tub fills up very slowly, so they can be out and about doing all kinds of things, and it takes slower for their tub to fill. And then their tubs drain really quickly, meaning they're over it and they're ready to go out and play again. And I love this analogy. I just think it's beautiful. And so right now, my tub is full and it's draining really, really slowly, which means that there's not a lot of room for anything else to be coming in because my tub is going to overflow. So I just need to be more gentle with myself and more compassionate. And we are going to get activated, and it is going to be harder to let go of things sometimes. And it doesn't mean that we're doing anything wrong. It just means that we're trying to process and figure things out. For me, setting limits to say, you know, I appreciate you wanting to give me information, but I don't think it's going to help. And the intention of me talking about this was not really to figure out why I wasn't included. It was really to focus on what it brought up for me and how can I do healing around that. Maybe that's wrong. Maybe there's an explanation that would make all this go away. I don't know. But I think it's really important for us to trust ourselves, to honor ourselves, to be gentle with ourselves, and to just be where we need to be. My hope is that this is, and again, my gremlins are like, how many times are you going to be talking about this? This is the third time you're talking about this. Well, I'm either going to talk about it or I'm going to experience it as many times as I need to, as long as I need to. My hope is that this is incredibly validating for you, the listener, and that you know that when we go through stuff, we just got to figure out ways to navigate it. And even though we get the gremlins and the judgment that comes up, that's just part of the process because we feel things deeply. We process things deeply. We want to figure things out and sort things out. And I think we have, some of us have a really strong need to try and grow and to heal. And that's what we want. And so we kind of want to keep going back in there until we figure out what it is. Whatever we need to do, however we need to handle conflicts, situations, we can trust that we know what's right for us at that moment, and we can re-choose at any time. So my hope is that this gives you permission to just be exactly where you're at today, to really honor and nurture what your needs are. I hope you found this helpful. If you're struggling in relationships, if you're struggling with wounding and you want to work with me, I love working with highly sensitive people. I think there's so much that we can do and so many ways that we can learn and increase our capacity and learn to really love and accept everything that comes up for us. If you're interested in working with me, you can go to unapologeticallysensitive@gmail.com. If you have any questions or comments about this episode, feel free to send me an email at unapologeticallysensitive@gmail.com. I've got a bunch of social media links, a closed Facebook group, an open Facebook group. You can find the links in the show notes. If you're listening on iTunes, you can scroll down, or if not, you can go to unapologeticallysensitive.com, click on the podcast link, and then click on the episode that this is, and all the information is there. Remember, sensitivity is nothing to apologize for. It's our superpower. Have a blessed day.